Hi everyone, Johnny here for Chaos Cards, and today we are opening up Stomp the Plank. Pack your trunks. So we have here a gorgeous game. It takes about 15 minutes to play. It is for those aged 5 and up, and is for 2 to 4 players. But you've got this gorgeous game, these lovely elephants, where you're going to be stomping the plank. Shocking. So, search Captain Giraffe's chest. Tilt your opponent's plank, but don't get caught, or your elephant will walk the plank. Beware, pack your trunks. Because you may go in the dunk. Right, let's open this up and show you what is inside. So we have our elephants. Whoop. We have here the rule book as well, which is quite nice. So we got our elephant pirate figurines. So we've got yellow, red, and blue, and there's green. Green and green gets a baggie. So they are quite cool and detailed. And all different colours. We've got our pontoon board. Our pontoon board. There. And our magnetic planks. So you can see the magnet there. We've got those. We've got our crate tokens and our free silica gel. Our treasure cards here as well. So let's read out the text. You are young and mischievous pirates. Try to steal treasures from Captain Giraffe's chest while accusing your fellow pirates. But be careful, because if you get caught, you'll walk the plank. For each treasure you manage to steal, your opponent will end up with a crate at the end of their plank, which might just tip over. The first one to fall loses the game. Okay, so let's take a look at these cards as well. And then we also need the boat, which is very important. The pirate ship box. So place the pirate ship in the middle of the play area, deck side facing up. There you go. Place the four magnetic planks on their intended places. So you go there, so you can see how they fit. You got those magnets going, which is very cute. Like so. There you go, lovely stuff. Each player chooses an elephant, so let's choose red. We're a big fan of red. Placing it on a plank. So let's pop it there. On the first base starting for the ship, place the pontoon board next to the ship. Shuffle the deck of treasure cards. We'll do a brief shuffle. And place it next to the pontoon board face down. Okay, we'll pop it there for now. Place the crate tokens so that each player can grab them easily. Get some of those out. Let's pop blue over here as an example. Choose the first active player, me. The active player reveals the first card of the draw pile. So we got red. And then places it on the leftmost available spot on the pontoon. Then they decide to either A, stop and end their turn. All the other players must then place crate tokens at the end of their plank equal to the number indicated above the last played card. So in this case, it would be none. If another player's plank tips over and their elephant falls into the water, that player loses the game. Or B, draw a new card and place it on the next available spot. Provided the player doesn't draw the same treasure card twice, they choose again to either stop A or draw B. If the player draws the same treasure card twice during their turn, they fail. They are caught by the captain and their turn is over. The active player must move their elephant one space forward on the plank. If their plank tips over, the elephant falls into the water and the player loses the game. I haven't done a proper shuffle, so I'm thinking there's a chance that this could be the same one, but let's go again. It is the same one. So, I'm caught by the captain, my turn is over, and I have to move my elephant one space forward on the plank. Like so. But it's all fine, we're all good at the minute. Let's move this over here, because then in this two-player game, we can see. At the end of the turn, discard all cards from the pontoon face up and place them in a discard pile. The player to the left of the active player becomes the new active player. So I'm going to give these a little bit of a slightly more randomized shuffle. And then we'll pull again from the deck for the blue player this time around. Okay, so blue player, let's go. So we got that one, we're gonna go again, we're gonna go again, and we're gonna go again. That is a treasure card that is the same twice. Now, I believe that does mean that, unfortunately, blue has to go forwards. And then we discard all of these. So let's go again for the red player. And let's stop there. We'll stop there as a red. And end my turn. All the other players must then place crate tokens at the end of their plank equal to the number indicated above the last played card. So two would go onto here. Now, I assume I can do that, or do they have to go as one? Let's see if there's any rules related to that. I think that might be legal. Yeah, that's legal. That is the way to do it. Now, it also says, if the active player ever manages to place a card on the final spot of the pontoon board without failing, they immediately win the game. So that is red to go. So we get rid of all these and then we go to blue. So blue turn. One, two, three. Let's go again. Okay, stopping. So three would go onto the red spot here. Let's do that. Okay, get intense. Let's go for the blue. The red player is going to go. Let's go one more. That is cool. Nice. So red is good. So blue has to put three on theirs. But we haven't had any additional failures just yet. Okay. Then we go with the blue player. Oh, who immediately flails, not yet, not in the water, but fails, so has to move one step forwards, but it's still fine. So now it's red's go. I'm gonna go one more. Ah, fail. And then we go back to blue, and you can see how if you're at higher player counts, you're adding more of these crate tokens onto your spot because maybe more people are failing or stopping or anything like that. So blue is going to stop there. So red has to put two on there. So that is all fine still. We're all good. All good. And the cardstock is really nice on these as well. Immediately red fails. So it has to move forward one. Getting tense. All right. So then blue player is going to go one more. Oh, amazing stuff. So red player has to put four crate tokens on the end of their plank. So this could be it. And then red falls into the dunk. So blue is the winner of this individual variant, but you could play the single winner variant where if there was more, you could keep playing until there was only one person left standing. But that is everything you need to know about Stomp the Plank. A great fun game, very simple, easy to get your hands on and get your head around as well. So thank you for watching this video. Make sure to check it out over on the TikTok shop and the online store. I've been Johnny for Chaos Cards, and I'll see you next time.